Hey guys, it's KJ for you, and welcome back to my Let's Play The Farce. This is episode 7, and I've been working really hard on some items over there, but first thing I want to do is pass the night. I worked the whole day, and now we're going to pass the night, and we're going to go over and check out what I've done. Actually, before we do that, let's go ahead and grab some of this food. I'm trying to grab all the food off this drying rack before we start using our other drying rack. And I also got a little bit more food. I killed a lizard in between videos. Alright, as you can see right here, I finished this little mini ramp walkway type thing. I also put some logs into what will eventually be my actual home. This is gonna be where I sleep. And check this out. I put down a bunch of stick holders and stone boulder holders and stuff like that. And over here is the garden. Now, the garden is actually awesome. Look at this. It makes blueberries. Oh, I didn't even know that. Oh, that's so good. The problem is, will the blueberries stay there? Because once I eat them, or pick them, I pick them, right? Actually, aren't you supposed to be able... Yeah, you're supposed to be able to pick them. You need a pouch for that. All right, we're not going to do that just yet. I'm actually waiting until I'm hungry. The thing is, out in the wild, blueberries, you pick them, but the plants don't go away. But I'm hoping here the plants will go away when I'm done, so we'll see how that goes. Planting some more. And we come over here, and we pick this stuff. Alright, so it seems like when you plant in here, you get random food, or random whatever, because I got blueberry, I got aloe vera, coneflower seems to be the majority of it. So that's pretty cool. So we're going to go ahead and make some herbal medicines, because we're running out of pills, and because the backpacks that the luggage from the planes don't respawn anymore. This is going to be very important, and we'll go ahead and make some energy mix as well, because why not. So it seems like chicory is the coneflower is used in both recipes, so maybe that's why. What is marigold for? What is marigold for? Oh yeah, that made the medicine. Okay, I'm not sure. Chicory, and this is, and that, okay. All right, fair enough. So we've got 4 medicine. Not great, but it's something, and it's some kind of renewable source of healing ourselves that will eventually be there. All right, a lot of you guys have been telling me to get the the katana. I'm debating if I want to farm now or get the katana. Honestly, the katana is kind of hard to get. I might not even get it. I'm really bad at finding the katana for some reason. I think we're going to do one more building episode. I think, assuming I remember, maybe we'll get the katana next episode. I really want to get some stuff built down here, and I got to keep remembering to collect sticks, because I have a hard time remembering to collect sticks. Okay, sticks. There we go. Sorry about my throat. Woke up like a couple hours ago, but man, like, my allergies are killing me. My throat's kind of like, ugh. It should get better as I go on, as I use it more. By the way, I do see rabbits coming through here quite often. Oh, there's a lizard. I do see rabbits coming through here quite often. I'm thinking about maybe making some rabbit traps. Let's set up some rabbit traps around here. Rabbit traps are kind of crappy, to be honest. The rabbits have to run directly through them. It's not like a video game mechanic where you set up a trap and you think you might have a certain amount of time, or a certain percentage of a rabbit getting trapped. No, the rabbits have to physically run, just happen to run through the trap. It's very, very realistic. But we'll just make a few for now. I won't make them right now, but I'll just put them up there so when I come through with some sticks... Actually, I do have some sticks. Might as well throw them in there. Man, they take a lot of sticks, dude. A lot of sticks. Hello, rabbit. Don't get yourself killed. I want to trap you. Yeah, you're supposed to be able to breed the rabbits. I've never been able to get the breeding to work properly. I'm not sure if the rabbits are actually bugged or what the deal is. So... But we'll give it a shot. You know, the farm was bugged for the gardens. I should probably make some more gardens, by the way. Anyway, the gardens were bugged forever, and now they actually work. Not only do they work, but they're pretty cool. So, you know, you give some time to some things. Did I bring my... Yeah, I did. No, I didn't. So you give some time to, you know, to the mechanics of the game, and things are going to get worked out. This game's been in alpha for a while. A lot of people don't like games being in alpha for so long. I kind of like it because they keep getting updated, you know? As long as they're updating the game, I really don't care. What I don't like is when a game comes out completely and then they, you know, that's it. They're not going to keep updating. It's a full-fledged game. They're done with it. The development team is going to move on. Sometimes you can look forward to modders, you know, taking the torch and, you know, modding the game and breathing new life into it like they did with Minecraft. But that's, you know, that's not usually the case. So a lot of people are like, oh, I hear a lot of people saying it's 7 days to die. Like, oh, 7 days to die, still an alpha. Maybe I'm a little bit defensive about my favorite game. It's very possible. As a matter of fact, I would say that's probably accurate. But I'm going to be defensive about the game I love, man. Like, what's wrong with it being an alpha? The only thing I don't like about 7 days to die's alpha is they're taking too long for the updates. But hey, man, like, they're, you know, they want the timetable on the way they want it. So that's going to be the way they're going to update it. I have mad respect for any developer or any entertainer, anybody who who does not take what people say, what their fans say, like 100% to heart. Because, you know, as a YouTuber, like, a lot of my fans want certain things, and you know, a lot of times they have good points, but sometimes, you know, it's the vocal minority. Like, sometimes it's just you know, they think they want something, but when they actually do it, it doesn't come out like they think it would. Or, you know, like, you got a couple people yelling really loud, they want this like that, and then the other people who like your stuff the way it is, or maybe we want you to do something a little different in another direction, they're not typing it out. So, you know, as far, because I know the fun pimps, like, I know a lot of these indie developers have their forums, and they take very seriously what people say on their forums, and I think for the most part, people do have pretty good ideas for the forums, but let's face it, we're not game developers, you know? Anybody can go on the forums and give some, you know, half-baked idea on how their game should be developed. I know I've done it. Well, maybe not on the forums, but I've talked about it. But then, like, when that's actually done, or when you really think about it, or, you know, if it's really done for unforeseen reasons, it doesn't work out the way you thought, and it was a bad idea. You know, so I leave it to the developers, and I think that the fun pimps and the people making this game and, you know, the people making all these indie games, you know, don't ignore your fan base. Listen to what they say. Think about what they say. But ultimately, it's your decision. And if you think at all that something someone suggested might not be a good idea, you should probably not do it. You're the developers. Not only that, but you gotta understand, like I said before, the people commenting on the videos, on the forums, the people, anybody getting in touch with you, giving you ideas, like, that was stupid, you should do it this way. That's the minority, man. That is the minority. 7 Days to Die sold over 1 million copies. You think a million people are putting in their 2 cents? No. A few people are putting in their 2 cents. So, you know, I don't know where I got off on that tangent. Oh, because, yeah, these updates. So, again, I like the updates. I like the way the forest gets updated. And if they're done with it, then it doesn't get updated anymore. We don't have any new stuff to look forward to. Here, let's eat these blueberries. Can I keep eating them? What happens when I eat them all? Alright, that's a problem. The blueberry bushes aren't gonna go away. Well, I mean, it is a really good food source. I mean, how is that a problem? The problem is, it seems to be, when you plant stuff in these gardens, what you're going to get back is going to be random, okay? You're either going to get back aloe, cone, chicory, marigold, although I didn't even got any marigold yet, or blueberries. Now, the problem is, when you get back to blueberries, the blueberry bushes are not going to go away. So eventually, law of averages, science, and all that stuff, you're going to have all blueberry things. And actually, I think when you eat the blueberries, I don't even know if you get the seeds back. Here, let's eat some more and see if we get the seeds back. Because if we don't get the seeds back, that's a real problem. Nope. You don't get seeds back. Nope. That's a problem. So eventually you're going to run out of everything. Basically what's going to happen is, You're going to pick the wilds out in the forest. I don't even know how you get seeds. I think you get seeds from picking flowers out in the wild. So you're going to pick your flowers out in the wild. Eventually, those are going to run out. You're not going to have anything left to pick. You're going to plant them here, and things are going to grow. You're gonna pick them, replant them, grow. Pick them, replant them, grow. Eventually, they're gonna come out like blueberries. Blueberry bushes don't go away, and eventually, you're just gonna have a bunch of blueberry bushes. And eventually, you will never be able to get any more aloe vera. Yeah, you won't be able to get any more of these. That's a finite resource, unless there's something I'm not seeing here, which is very possible. I should probably look up how to get seeds, but I'm pretty sure it's just when you pick the flowers. I don't know how else you get seeds. That's a bummer. That's a damn bummer. I'll probably make some more, plots. Maybe even this video. Actually, I probably should make them this video. Yeah, that sucks, man. I was hoping that would be a renewable, like, forever source of healing. And it doesn't look like that's the case. Oh, I should use my sticks when I went back there. Oh, well. Let's use them now. Alright, well, we'll see. We'll see where things go. I thought I had some more stuff up here. Let me look around. Yep, there it is. Okay. That's a bummer. I'm gonna keep an eye on my seeds. I think between this video and next, hopefully if I remember, I will look up how you get seeds, exactly. I mean, you should get seeds by eating blueberries. I mean, you get seeds from picking the flowers. Why wouldn't you get them from eating the blueberries? Maybe there's some way I could take the blueberries out of there. Like, remove the bush. That wouldn't really help, because I'd be using a seed to put down a blueberry bush. The only way it would work is if by removing the blueberry bush, I get some seeds back. I doubt that will be the case. Let's go put down some more farms here. And we'll grab some more sticks in the meantime. I'm hoping I remember next video. I have every intention of trying to get the katana next video. Now, there's a couple things that can go wrong with getting the katana. First of all, I could forget to try and get the katana. You know, it's a very, if you've been watching my videos, you'll know that that's a very real possibility. Or, I could try and get the katana and fail. Again, it would not be the first time. Excuse me. So, yeah. I have the best intentions to try and get the katana. By the way, there is a way to make a bridge going from... I could make a small platform. Someone pointed out in the comments. Here, I'll show you right now because it's important. Go. What's going on? Oh, I must have had the book out, but since I had my hands on the log site, it was kind of bugged out a little bit. Alright. So, here's the deal, guys. Someone told me in the comments that you could... there is an anchor for tree bridges on the platforms you can make. Now, I thought they meant, when they said that, I thought they meant custom foundation platforms, which is what I always work with. These have no anchors. But what they meant was this platform right here does have anchors. And the thing about this is this would be very cheap to make. I could like go to the real island I wanted to build on without a bridge. Excuse me. I could go on the real island I wanted to build without a bridge, build that platform very cheaply, and then connect it to a tree platform on the mainland, and then build the tree platform from the mainland. It would work. The reason I'm choosing not to do it is because I think I'd have a very hard time getting the log sled across that tree bridge. And it's a lot of work for it not to work, you know what I mean? Like, you'd have to make a tree platform and then a staircase up to the tree platform, and then... Actually, I wouldn't have to make a staircase up to the tree platform. I could just maybe make a custom foundation around the tree bridge, kind of line it up, and then make a staircase going up to that, bring it up to that, and go along the tree bridge. It might work. The reason I chose against it is because it's risky. I could put a lot of time, work, you know, a lot of time and effort and a lot of logs into that build, and then maybe it wouldn't work. I'm going to stick with the plan I'm doing now, but maybe I will try that plan next season. Actually, that might be a good... Why did I use that on that? I wanted to make farms. Damn it. Actually, that's a pretty good idea. I will try that next season. Again, assuming I remember. You know? So, we'll see. Okay, let's see what we got here. More blue... Yeah, there's little blueberry bushes, man. They're not going anywhere. I mean, I'm going to be well fed. That's pretty cool, but I need healing. Yeah, this is all blueberry bushes. Ah, damn it. Sucks. And I'm not getting seeds back for eating the blueberries. Mother effing A. That blows. That's a problem. They gotta change that. Get on it, developers of the game that I don't know your names. Okay. Yeah, that's a bummer. Oh, I should probably set up more anyway. Alright, let's see what we got here. Garden. They're very cheap too, which is nice. I'll have to drag over like 50 freaking logs. Garden. I'll leave space that, so I can walk in between them. Here, let's do this. There we go. Eh. Another best looking garden in the world, but whatever. Ah, that's... No, I can't. I can't have that. That will drive me up an effing wall. It's gotta be somewhat lined up. Along with this one. It's almost impossible to line those up both ways. Is that lined up? Yeah, it's pretty lined up. Alright, one more. Yep, okay. Looking good. Looking good. Alright, let's go get some logs. Also, I think I'm gonna look for some... things to pick out there, so maybe I can get some more seeds. It sucks though because I don't know. Maybe they do grow back. I don't think those plants grow back in the wild, but they should. Now, if they grew back in the wild, I guess I'd be okay with these turning all into blueberry bushes. It's a little stupid though. You're gonna end up with just like 50 freaking blueberry bushes everywhere. It's like idiotic, and like I'm gonna have so much food. I mean, that's nice, I guess. I won't have to hunt anymore. That's a plus. But damn. Alright. It is getting dark. Let me look for some bushes really quick. It gets dark in this game very quickly. We're also looking for sticks. I've seen, cannibals over here. That's why I'm a little nervous right now. Okay. Ah, crap. I forgot to put this up. Oh, well. I don't really need it anymore now that I got the, the blueberry bushes. I'm not sure if I can carry two of these. Can I? Oh, yeah, can. Come on, give me something to pick, damn it. Ah, come on. I'm getting scared. Somebody said I could do spear fishing too, but I don't really need to. I don't need food anymore. I got 19,000 blueberry bushes back at my base that won't go away. Come on, find something to pick, damn it. I probably ran by stuff to pick already, and you guys are probably really... Oh, boy. You guys are probably really aggravated about that. Cage, you passed by at 13 minutes and 49 seconds, a blueberry bush you could have picked. Yeah, I know. It happens. It happens a lot with me. Should I try and outrun these guys or fight them? I'm gonna outrun them. It's a shame I didn't get to pick anything. I also left my log sled out there. It might get taken. That's a bummer. You know what? Let's put these up while I'm thinking about it. Why is the second one edible? I only had it for like a minute. It's supposed to be fresh. I wouldn't care if these things spoiled. I would just throw them away. The thing is, I don't think you can throw them away. I think if they spoil in your inventory, they stay there unless you put them on a drying rack, which is really annoying. Unless I'm missing something. Ah, damn it. I didn't get any more seeds. I've been meaning to put down some standing fire here, so let's do that right now. Standing fire. Kind of in the water, but that's okay. No rocks. It's okay. We'll finish it at some point. Should I go looking again? Yeah, let's go looking again. We got a couple minutes left. Alright, what do we got up here? Hopefully no baddies. I don't see any baddies. I also don't see any flowers to pick. I really want to pick some flowers before this day, before I end this video. I don't know why it's so important to me, but it is. Come on, man. All right, I think I'm gonna admit defeat and head home. That doesn't sound like me. Let's make a torch. Come in. Stupid mushrooms, all I see. I've got a bush there, but that's not what I want. Come on, game. Don't make my people hear the timer go off. Oh, here we go. Marigold. Yep, two seeds collected for that. Well, at least you get two seeds for collecting it. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm going to do some research on seeds and flowers, see what I can find out. If you guys have any tips, let me know in the comments for sure. I'm going to call this one here. That is going to be it for... Oh my god, what the hell. Alright, well, let's hold on. Could be exciting running back. Oh my god, these freaking guys. Can you just leave me alone? I come on their island, chop down their sacred trees, kill their wildlife, pick their flowers. I'm like, can't you just leave me alone? Can you tell I'm American? Okay, almost there. Almost there. All right. Right. Whoa, how did I get up here? And more importantly, how did I get down? Ugh, I'm just gonna jump. I really don't care. It's annoying. I just wanna get home. Okay, guys. Okay. So that is going to do it for episode 7, and I will see you next time for episode 8. Till then, take it easy.